of 1812 fought between United State of America and United Kingdom during 1812 to 1815. In June 1812, the United States declared war against Great Britain in reaction to three issues: the British economic blockade of France, the impressment of thousands of neutral American seamen into the British Royal Navy against their will, and the British support of hostile Indian tribes along the Great Lakes frontier. After many battles, the war was ended in 1814 by the Treaty of Ghent. Primary reasons of the War of 1812 involved the Royal Navy preventing and seizing American ships on the open sea and influencing men as British subjects, including those with American citizenship certificates. On June 1, 1812, President James Madison sent a message to Congress recounting American grievances against Great Britain, though not specifically calling for a declaration of war. The House of Representatives then deliberated for 4 days behind closed doors before voting 79-49, 61%, in favor of the first declaration of war. The Senate agreed in the declaration by a 19-13, 59%, vote in favor. The declaration focused mostly on maritime issues, especially involving British blockades, with two-thirds of the indictment devoted to such impositions, initiated by Britain's orders in council. The conflict began formally on June 18, 1812, when Madison signed the measure into law. He proclaimed it the next day, while it was not a formal declaration of war. The U.S. Congress declared war with majorities in both its House and Senate as required in the Constitution of the United States. Though the votes were strictly along party lines, the Federalists were outvoted in every section of the country. U.S. President James Madison approved a three-pronged assault against Canada. As a colony of Great Britain, Canada was swept up in the War of 1812 and was invaded a number of times by the Americans. The war was fought in Upper Canada, Lower Canada, on the Great Lakes and the Atlantic, and in the United States. The war had been preceded by years of diplomatic dispute, yet neither side was ready for war when it came. Britain was heavily engaged in the Napoleonic Wars. Most of the British Army was deployed in the Peninsular War in Portugal and Spain, and the Royal Navy was blockading most of the coast of Europe. The number of British regular troops present in Canada in July 1812 was officially 6,034, supported by additional Canadian militia. Throughout the war, the British War Secretary was Earl Bathurst, who had few troops to spare for reinforcing North America defenses during the first 2 years of the war. He urged Lieutenant General George Prevost to maintain a defensive strategy. Prevost, who had the trust of the Canadians, followed these instructions and concentrated on defending Lower Canada at the expense of Upper Canada, which was more vulnerable to American attacks and allowed few offensive actions. Unlike campaigns along the East Coast, Prevost had to operate with no support from the Royal Navy. The United States was also not prepared for war. Madison had assumed that the state militias would easily seize Canada and that negotiations would follow. In 1812, the regular army consisted of fewer than 12,000 men. Congress authorized the expansion of the army to 35,000 men, but the service was voluntary and unpopular, it paid poorly, and there were initially few trained and experienced officers. The militia objected to serving outside their home states. They were undisciplined and performed poorly against British forces when called upon to fight in unfamiliar territory. Multiple militia refused orders to cross the border and fight on Canadian soil. The Royal Navy cut off maritime trade and allowed the British to raid the Atlantic coast at will. British initiated land offensives in the U.S. Northwest Territory with Indian allies, and the Americans looked elsewhere for British vulnerability. The first American attempts to invade the Ontario Peninsula could not occupy any territory as the British had done in the U.S., nor were U.S. troops ever successful in building a fort anywhere in Canada. The British and Indians defeated one initiative on U.S. soil south of the treaty middle of the Great Lakes at the Siege of Detroit, and a second U.S. effort to cut off supplies to warring tribes at the Battle of Queenston Heights. In 1813, the United States won the Battle of Lake Erie, gaining control of the southern shore, and it defeated Tecumseh's Confederacy at the Battle of the Thames in its Old Northwest with 120 U.S. Army and 3,500 militia auxiliaries from states and Indian allies. The victory recovered the eastern part of the Old Northwest from the British. However, the British defeated two American attempts to capture Montreal, the supply entrepot for British Allied Indians. An American invasion of the Niagara Peninsula to end the military supply to Indian proxies by Lake Erie achieved no decisive results. Another attempt in the summer of 1814 failed at the Battle of Lundy's Lane. The defeat of Napoleon in spring 1814 freed up British troops for use in North America. In August 1814, the British burned Washington, including the White House and the Capitol. The Americans then repulsed additional British raids on Baltimore and New York, and the end of 1814 saw an end to British-American conflict to the north. News of the peace treaty took almost 2 months to cross the Atlantic, and British forces were not informed of the end of hostilities in time to end their drive against the mouth of the Mississippi River. On January 8, 1815, a large British army attacked New Orleans and was decimated by an inferior American force under General Andrew Jackson, in the most spectacular U.S. victory of the war. The American public heard of the Battle of New Orleans and the Treaty of Ghent at approximately the same time, fostering a greater sentiment of self-confidence and shared identity throughout the young republic. After the British burned the White House during the War of 1812, President James Madison and his wife were unable to live there. Madison's successor, James Monroe, moved back into the White House in 1817, while it was still being rebuilt. In the war, casualties are as follows: 2,260 dead, 4,505 wounded. The War of 1812 pitted the young United States in a war against Great Britain, from whom the American colonies had won their independence in 1783. In Britain's effort to control the world's oceans, the British Royal Navy encroached upon American maritime rights and cut into American trade during the Napoleonic Wars. The effects of this war were the decrease in Native American resistance, increased American patriotism, strengthened the nation, increased manufacturing, and decreased political party divisions. The War of 1812 was crucial for the United States. It effectively destroyed the Indians' ability to resist American expansion east of the Mississippi River. The Treaty of Ghent. In December 24, 1814, the Treaty of Ghent was signed by British and American representatives at Ghent, Belgium, ending the War of 1812. By terms of the treaty, all conquered territory was to be returned, and commissions were planned to settle the boundary of the United States and Canada. The American victory on Lake Champlain led to the conclusion of U.S. British peace negotiations in Belgium, and on December 24, 1814, the Treaty of Ghent was signed, ending the war. Although the treaty said nothing about two of the key issues that started the war, the rights of neutral U.S. vessels and the impressment of U.S. sailors, it did open up the Great Lakes region to American expansion and was hailed as a diplomatic victory in the United States.